And welcome back. Even though Hot Shops is grounded in molten material, they do house a number of artists with a little less heat in their format. Painter Paula Wallace has won awards for her landscapes and illustrations, but she says her greatest masterpiece is introducing art to the less fortunate.
I've been very fortunate. I do work with an organization, Y Arts, and Y Arts really is meant to serve all of those people on the fringes. And I think when you work with those people who might not always get the attention, the special needs children, the refugee adults, the people who have experienced some kind of brokenness, you give them a kind of superpower that lets them give voice to something, and it acknowledges them as amazing, creative human beings. I think it's what I'm supposed to do. I've been making art forever, and I always think that my paintings, even a landscape, is in a way an illustration. It's inspired by the horizon, the incredible sky, the fields, farms, the buildings, whatever happens to be in that, in whatever you're viewing. But an illustration is very specific to a text. So frequently with my landscapes, they're also related to text, okay. Poetry or literature. Not everybody's going to like every piece of art, and not everybody's going to appreciate or understand every story, but it's there for someone. I think every painting I make, I don't want to keep it. It's not mine to keep. I am making it for somebody else. And it becomes, in a way, a kind of sacred object. I'm holding it for a time, and then I have to let it go. What I'm going to have you do is work on this moon. I'm really lucky that I landed here. It's a divine intervention. I have a ready pool of honest friends. You know, the people who will tell you, well, that's not working so well. Try this. That works. Don't change that. It's a place to make our mess. And you know, this is where you come to work. And you're working, even though you're working in isolation to a certain extent, you're also under one roof. And you get that vibe. You get that pool of knowledge. There are always going to be those of us who need to create. I think everybody has something in them that calls them to create. It might be music, it might be writing, it might be dancing. It could be any number of things. And it may not even be the actual act of doing it, but that you need it to feel human, that you go to theater, or you listen to music, or you look at art. I think about a professor I had a gazillion years ago who always said it took as much creativity to look at art as it does to make it.
Hot Shops is part of an exciting artistic landscape in Omaha. But if you want to explore other options, there's the Summer Arts Festival. There's the Joslyn Art Museum. It has a new exhibit and admission is always free. Or if you want to scope out a new show, check out omahaperformingarts.org for a complete list of performers headed into the metro area. Whether you're into art, music, theater, or film, there's something here for you. So hit the metro art scene and try something new. Then let us know what you think. You can email your comments to news@ketv.com. We like hearing from you. Remember, if you missed any part of this show or you want to watch it again, you can check online at ketv.com. Just go to our homepage, click on the menu button, then look for Chronicle. Special thanks to KETV photojournalist and Hot Shops artist Dan Griskoviak for helping put this show together. Also, producer Jasmine Putney. I'm Rob McCartney. Thanks for watching. We'll see you back here again next Sunday morning for KETV NewsWatch 7's Chronicle.